I'd like to call the Roseville City Council meeting for October 24th, 2017 to order. Today we have our Roseville Honor Guard present. Gentlemen, if we could all rise for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you, Lieutenant Blerick and the Honor Guard. Mr. Clerk, if we could have roll call, please.
Councilman Wetisha.
Present.
Councilman Shoemaker.
Here.
Councilwoman McCartney.
Here.
Councilwoman Ha.
Here.
Councilman Frontera.
Present.
Mayor Pro Tem Haggerty.
Here.
Mayor Taylor.
Here.
Show all members present here this evening, Mayor.
Thank you, Mr. Steelen. Next item on the agenda is our consent agenda. Are there any items on the consent agenda council wishes to have removed for discussion? Councilman Frontera.
Yes, I have a question on item F regarding the agreement to enter with Macomb County Department of Roads for the 13-mile project. Glenn, I'm not sure if you'll be able to answer this, and if not, maybe you can get back with us. The 13-mile project agreement has a administrative fee of 3%. Do we know who gets that 3% of administrative fee and what that was used for?
Councilman, I'm not sure who gets that administrative fee. I would believe it's probably the county, since they are the body administering that contract. I will check and get back to you.
Okay. And then, again, if you might not know, but is this customary to be charged an administrative fee for an intergovernmental contract like this?
I don't know the answer to that either. I will check.
Can I respond to that?
Yes.
Yes. So the Macomb County Road Commission has changed the practice in the way they execute these contracts with all municipalities within the county. Previously, that was a cost that they would incur solely and would not charge the communities for that. The past couple of years, they have been including the administrative fee to be split among all the parties that are involved in the contract. So that is, it's not unusual, quite frankly. We do it with our intergovernmental bodies. For instance, CERISA, we charge administrative fees for providing certain services to CERISA, et cetera. So it's not unusual.
Okay. That's all the questions I had.
Any other items on the consent agenda council wishes to have removed for discussion? If not, I need a motion to approve the consent agenda.
So moved.
Support.
A motion Motion by Councilwoman Hawes, supported by Councilman Letitia. All in favor?
Aye.
Anyone against? Motion carries. Next item on the agenda is going to be approval of request abatement. We have none tonight. Move into presentations, and we have Chief Berlin here, and if we, if council could join Chief Berlin down at the podium. Chief and Lieutenant Glan- or Deputy Chief Glandon.
Good evening, everyone, and thank you all for coming this evening. On behalf of the Roseville Police Department, I'd like to thank you all for coming this evening as we say goodbye to some old friends, and we welcome some new ones as they start the beginning of their careers. According to the Cambridge American Dictionary, a volunteer is a person who does something, especially for other people or for an organization, willingly and without forced or paid to do it. Think of that for a second. A person who does something, especially for other people or for an organization, willingly and without being forced or paid to do it. Tonight we're going to honor three people who have fit that definition to a T, and they have for many, many years. We have an organization here within the city and the police department. It's our Roseville Police Reserve. And they wear the uniform and the badge and a gun of a police officer, but they are not paid to do that job. But yet they show up at events throughout our city throughout the year, freely, voluntarily, on their own time, and a great deal of their own expense. And just like your regular officers, you know, they're just as much of a target as the rest of us for the slings and arrows of some of our citizenry. And tonight we wish to honor three of them as they're calling their time as a Roseville Police Reserve, bring it to an end. And we'd like to recognize Police Reserve John Mills. John didn't make it tonight. Okay. Police Reserve Al Neiman. Al has been with the Roseville Police Reserve Unit for 22 years. And we'd also like to recognize Police Reserve Ed Vio. Ed's been with the Reserve Unit for 30 years. This evening, we'd also like to recognize three of our newest officers. When you're hired as a Roseville police officer, you go through the original application process, you go through a psychological, you go through a background check, you're then hired, and you go through a field training program, which takes many, many months. You're then on probation for a year. In the course of that time, when you're on probation, you wear a badge, but it has no badge number on it. And that signifies to other officers that you are, in fact, a probationary. But general public wouldn't know the difference. But tonight, they're going to get their badge with a badge number upon it. But as we've watched the political upheaval in our country over here the last few years, and as it seems an endless tirade of anti-police rhetoric every single evening on the news, and it's become more and more difficult to attract individuals to police work. So it's with a great honor that I welcome these three members to our department, because they're willing to stand up, brave those slings and arrows, and risk their lives for the citizenry of our country. And unfortunately, those type of individuals are coming fewer and fewer. So tonight, I'd like to recognize, first off, Officer Matthew Lesperance. Matthew joined the Roseville Police Department after growing up in Clinton Township. He says here that he graduated the Police Academy in 1999. I don't think he's old enough for that one, so I think that was So I think that might be a little typo. He's a graduate of Oakland University, and where he obtained two degrees in criminal justice and general studies. And he worked for 3 years as a police cadet for the city of New Haven before joining the police, the Roseville Police Department. He'd like me, on his behalf, to thank his parents, his grandparents, and Tim and Carrie Wiley. And he'll have his girlfriend, Nikki Pollack, pin his badge on after City Clerk Steelen administers the oath of office.
Please raise your right hand and repeat after me. I am Matthew Lesperance.
I am Matthew Lesperance.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of Michigan.
And the Constitution of the State of Michigan.
I will faithfully enforce the laws of this state.
I will faithfully enforce the laws of this state.
And the ordinances of the City of Roseville.
And the ordinances of the City of Roseville.
And perform the duties of police officer.
And perform the duties of police officer.
To the best of my ability.
To the best of my ability.
Without allowing my personal feelings.
Without allowing my personal feelings.
Prejudices.
Prejudices.
Or animosities.
Or animosities.
Or friendships.
Or friendships.
To influence my decisions.
To influence my decisions.
I recognize the badge of my office.
I recognize the badge of my office.
As a symbol of public faith.
As a symbol of public faith.
And I accept as a public trust.
And I accept as a public trust.
To be held so long.
To be held so long.
As I am true to the ethics of police service.
As I am true to the ethics of police service.
Congratulations.
Thanks.
We'd now like to recognize Officer Jeffrey Wozniak. Jeffrey's originally from Utica, Michigan, and before he joined the Detroit Police Department, where he spent 20 years patrolling the streets of Detroit and working in their technical service section as well as their narcotics section. Upon his retirement, Jeffrey had a whole host of options that he could have undertaken rather than continuing in police work. But instead, he chose to continue serving the public and our citizenry, and we're very, very grateful that he chose the City of Roseville to do so. So he'd like me to thank Frances Simcoe, who's his mother, for I guess everything in his life. And he'll have on his stepfather, Joe Simcoe, will pin his badge of office on after receiving the oath of office from Clerk Steelen.
Raise your right hand and repeat after me. I, Jeffrey Wozniak.
I, Jeffrey Wozniak.
That was close. Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of Michigan.
And the Constitution of the State of Michigan.
I will faithfully enforce the laws of this state.
I will faithfully enforce the laws of this state.
And the ordinances of the City of Roseville.
And the ordinances of the City of Roseville.
And perform the duties of police officer.
Perform the duties of police officer.
To the best of my ability.
To the best of my ability.
Without allowing my personal feelings.
Prejudices.
Prejudices. Animosities.
Animosities.
Or friendships.
Or friendships.
To influence my decisions.
To influence my decisions.
I recognize the badge of my office.
I recognize the badge of my office.
As a symbol of public faith.
As a symbol of public faith.
I accept as a public trust.
And I accept as a public trust.
To be held so long.
To be held so long.
As I am true to the ethics of police service.
As I am true to the ethics of police service.
Congratulations.
And last but not least, Officer Lauren Brockman. Lauren's joining us after growing up in Romeo, Michigan, and she's a 2016 graduate of Macomb Police Academy and a graduate of Macomb Community College, where she earned her degree in law enforcement. She would like me to thank her family and friends for all the support they've given her leading up to this day. And she'd like to have her father, Leonard Brockman, pin her badge on after receiving the oath of office from Clerk Steelen. Where do you slide off to?
Please raise your right hand and repeat after me. I, Lauren Brockman.
I, Lauren Brockman.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of Michigan.
And the Constitution of the State of Michigan.
I will faithfully enforce the laws of this state.
I will faithfully enforce the laws of this state.
And the ordinances of the city of Roseville.
And the ordinances of the city of Roseville.
And perform the duties of police officer.
And perform the duties of police officer.
To the best of my ability.
To the best of my ability.
Without allowing my personal feelings.
Without allowing my personal feelings.
Prejudices.
Prejudices.
Animosities.
Animosities.
Or friendships.
Or friendships.
To influence my decisions.
To influence my decisions.
I recognize the badge of my office.
I recognize the badge of my office.
As a symbol of public faith.
As a symbol of public faith.
And I accept it as a public trust.
And I accept it as a public trust.
To be held so long.
To be held so long.
As I am true to the ethics of police service.
As I am true to the ethics of police service.
Congratulations.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very, very much as we welcome the three newest members of the Roseville Police Department.
Once again, thank you, Chief Berlin, and congratulations on our new retiree reserves, and welcome to our new police officers. Next item on the agenda is going to be hearing of the public. Hearing of the public are designated. Public comments on agenda items will only be heard at the first hearing. Second hearing of the public will be for any city business. Upon approaching the podium, please state your name and address, address the chair. You're welcome to direct questions, input information, and express opinions to the council. Anyone using inappropriate language will leave the podium, will be asked to leave the podium, will be called out of order, and will correct your language or leave the podium. Limit your remarks not to exceed 3 minutes. Anyone not adhering to these rules will be called out of order by the chair. Anyone from the public wish to be heard on any agenda item only at the first hearing of the public. If not, we'll move into the next item on the agenda, which is new business. First item under new business is public hearing and regarding rezoning request for a portion of the property located at 20733 13 Mile Road from B2 Community Business to B3 General Business. Mr. Sexton.
Yes, this property is located at the Rose Mac Shopping Center at 13 Mile and Little Mac. They're proposing to split a small section behind the Speedway gas station. They're going to split that parcel off and rezone it to B3. It's their intent to allow a drive-through business, which is not allowed in a B2 district.
Okay. Any questions for Mr. Sexton on this agenda item? Well, with that, what are the wishes of the board?
Well, Mayor, this is a public hearing. You have to open it up to
the
public
hearing. This is a public hearing. Is there anyone from the public wish to be heard on this agenda item?
Mayor, I would also like to point out that this comes with a recommendation from the Planning Commission for approval. Okay. A unanimous vote of the Planning Commission.
All right, thank you. Anyone from the public wish to be heard on this agenda item? Now I need a motion to close the public hearing.
So moved.
I have a motion by Mayor Pro Tem Haggerty, supported by Councilwoman McCartney, to close the public hearing. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Anyone against? Public hearing is closed. Next item on the agenda is going to be discussion and/or action regarding rezoning request for a portion of the property located at 2017. I think I got a typo here. I got too many threes in here, I think. I got 2073? Is it 201733 on mine.
20733.
Okay. Located at 20733 13 Mile from B2 Community Business to B3 General Business.
Mayor, I'll make the motion as presented.
Support.
I have a motion by Councilwoman Haw, supported by Councilwoman McCartney, to support the rezoning as requested. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Anyone against? Motion carries. Next item on the agenda is appointments. We have none tonight. Moving into reports, administration departments. Moving to reports from our city clerk, Mr. Steelen.
Mayor, I'd just like to report that we have received, obviously, all of our new voting equipment. We have trained all of our election inspectors. It was very welcomed by all the election inspectors. It's very user-friendly. I'm looking forward to rolling it out for this election. And that's really all I have to report this evening. If any questions, I'm happy to answer.
Any questions for our city clerk? Thank you, Mr. Steelen. Next item on the agenda is reports from our city manager, and filling in for our city manager is our billing director, Mr. Sexton.
Mayor, I have no items to report, but I would like to welcome the three new officers to the Roseville Police Department.
Thank you. Any questions for Mr. Sexton? If not, we'll move to the next item on the agenda, which is reports from our city attorney, Mr. Towns.
I'm going to be extremely lost this weekend as we did not get the official library report. So, not sure what I have on my agenda now.
Well, I know
Mr. Atkins being absent is really screwing my whole weekend up here. The only thing I do have to report, Mayor and Council, is you will see a new ordinance dealing with minor in possession and consumption of alcohol. State law has changed recently with regard to that, making it a civil infraction for a first offense, as well as changing the law with regard to second and third offenses. Afterward, those do remain misdemeanors, but in order for us to be compliant with that state law and not go beyond what they have allowed us to adopt, we are proposing revisions, which you should have in the very near future. Other than that, I have nothing further to report.
Any questions for Mr. Thompson? Mr. Thompson, is that does the fine change on that at all, or does the fine stay the same?
No, there are some changes to the penalties with regard to fines as well. They have reduced a first-time offense to a civil infraction. I want to say it's $100, if I'm not mistaken, for a first-time offender. Again, second offender and third offender. And
it was up to 500, correct?
It was up to 500. All of our MIPs previously were pursuant to state statute, which did allow up to a $500 fine, but that has changed.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Tomlinson. Next item on the agenda is our second hearing of the public. Second hearing of the public will be for any city business. Upon approaching the podium, please state your name and address, address the chair. You're welcome to direct questions, input information, or express opinions of the council. And when using appropriate language, be called out of order. We'll correct your language or leave the podium. Limit your remarks not to exceed 3 minutes. Anyone not adhering to these rules, be called out of order by the chair. Good evening.
Lowski 26055 Arlington Street. Last meeting I was here, Chief Randazzo was supposed to be here, and for whatever reason he had to cancel. So I'm asking the council if they could ask him back and please put it on the agenda, because apparently he made a visit down here unexpectedly. And there's a few of us that have some questions for him. Last meeting I was here, I also asked Mr. Atkins about the cost of the kennel. He said there was no cost to the city. I'm kind of curious about who's paying for all the new cement, the doors, the locks, the mats, and et cetera. What happened to the animal control truck? If we sold it, how come it didn't get bidded out? I asked about the one-year-old vehicle we purchased between $75,000 and $80,000. Why did we need this vehicle? How come we have so many dead animals laying around on the streets? Not just main streets, all around the city. And animal control from Macomb County does not just stay in our city. He travels through Macomb, so he's not here on everything. And if he gets a call, it takes some time to get back. And council, you guys looked at the numbers, the contract animal control out that was provided to you. And I guess who was in charge of animal control budgets for the last 5 years? And yes, if the city will be charged, if the county comes in and does work overtime, they will be charged. It's not included in that package. So council, are you willing to say that the ACO contract with Macomb County will not cost the city taxpayers no more than $580,000 in the next 5 years? And if my numbers are wrong, I'd like to get them corrected. I've been having a hard time getting copies of some things. So if the numbers are wrong, then I'll see where I'm at. But right now, the numbers that I have don't match up with what you guys were provided. So I would like to really find out what's going on and if this contract is going to cost the city more than $580,000 in the next 5 years. If someone could answer that, thank you very much.
Thank you. Anyone else in the public wish to be heard on any city business?
Kristen Hoff, 29535 Garden Court. Just a little info, you know, Kristen stands for the anointed, and Hoff stands for hope. And I say that because I see it reads church above you on your little emblem there. So as a woman of God, I have a few questions. Thank you, Darren. When you pledge your allegiance to that false idol right there, does that mean you're taking an oath to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth? Or does that mean you're pledging exactly what it stands for now? Lies and deceit and bribery and communist socialism? The reason I ask is because if I asked you how much Rizzo bribed you to use their corrupt and lazy business, would you even tell me the truth, or do you even know what the truth is? Do you even know the definition of it? And I just, you know, want to conclude that everyone sitting before me, if you've ever taken a bribe in your entire life, you sold your soul. And I hope that God Almighty can show you mercy, because I would not. And I guess I can conclude with saying, welcome to World War III.
Anyone else in the public wish to be heard on any city business?
Joe Cassio, 29411 Callahan, Roseville, Michigan. I just have a few concerns as a taxpaying resident. The city continues to talk about financial concerns, so I'd like to know if it's necessary for the chief of police to drive around in that $70,000 to $80,000 vehicle at our taxpayers' expense, especially because he is on a drop program. And for those of you that don't know what the drop program is, it's where you collect your full pay and your full pension. So not a luxury that most of us can afford. And this he has been doing for several years now. And if this program is a money saver for our city, then why hasn't it been offered to the other unions, such as the water department, the clerical, or the DPW? It just seems like it's for the privileged. And the chief's outdated views has cost the city more than just monetarily. He continues to tarnish the city's reputation, even causing the governor to change a state law when he had told that resident to drop dead for simply warming up his car. And I believe he was supposed to be disciplined for that. I don't know whatever became of that. And I believe Chief Berlin did receive an award from the Police Officers Association of Michigan. And to put it in better words than they had put it, it was voted for being the state's worst police chief, bringing more disgrace and embarrassment to our city. And please don't get me wrong, strong leadership is essential, but is this who we want to continue representing our city? All that while he's not even a resident of Roseville.
Anyone else in the public wish to be heard on any city business?
Mayor, just to clarify, the drop as defined by Mr. Castro, that is not the way the drop program works whatsoever. So I think it's inappropriate for the residents to be misled in such fashion. And I think also just recently, if I'm not mistaken, our police chief was appointed by Governor Snyder to the marijuana task force that deals with the new Medical Marijuana Facilities Act. So obviously the state has a great deal of respect for his abilities and his guidance and leadership in some of those other areas.
Thank you for that, Mr. Thomason.
Gerald Burak, 28673 Sunray Court, Chesterfield, Michigan. If you were watching Channel 7 last October 3rd, you would have seen the video of the police or the crash, or the video of the police responding to the crash of Catherine Steenland with James Nielsen, who swore she was drunk. If you haven't seen it, go to WXYZ.com and search Catherine Steenland, and you can watch it. Now, this is what I've been saying for a long time, for months here, and Richard used to try to stop me from speaking here last May when I brought this up. If you will search this, if judge pleads guilty, this is a Macomb, www.macombdaily.com discussion top X, which I brought up before. Now, the first comment on there is, I wonder how many times she's been pulled over in Roseville and got away with it, because they all try to protect one another. And God bless West Branch Police Department for not letting her get away with drunk driving before. And if you would search before, months ago, or I never got to say this before, because I cut off, but all you had to do was Google, Chief of Police James Berlin wants to kill cats and dogs. And this huge website would come up, and it just went on forever, just people with cats and dogs or cats and dogs. And you can't do that anymore, but according to this citizen, one of your own citizens, if you search Concerned Citizens of Roseville on Facebook, you can see this. And last September 7th, they tried to entrap me at this motel over here, and it's all on tape, but we can't hear the tape. Now, who's lying? And then when Jacob Sidway crashed into me, there's a video of it. There are pictures of the accident. There's an audio of Fred Servi swearing to me on phone that I'm going to get the video of the accident. He never signed the ticket. I've got a better driving record than Jacob Sidway, and I was found guilty when they withhold all that evidence. A video, pictures of the accident. They deleted my police report where I state that that Sidway ran the stop sign and was speeding, and I was found guilty. And the same thing, it's all on tape, why can't we hear this tape if they're telling the truth? Who's lying? And who has to videotape everybody in this police department? And could we get Rory Wagner back here? This police department got Rory Wagner trying to kill himself. I could get him back here and testify, because the last time I talked to him, he swore he was going to testify too, that I was framed by this police department. Oh yeah. Here's my evidence.
Mayor, we are at 3.
Well, I'd just like to leave.
You have to conclude your remarks, sir.
Okay, I just want to leave 3 pieces of
sir,
evidence.
No, you're going to have to conclude your remarks.
I am concluding them. Here's hey. I tried to get witnesses to this accident. That's when I found
sir,
out
you're
going to
have to conclude your remarks and leave the podium.
Here's the police report of
sir, you're
going
to have to leave the podium. Anyone else in the public wish to be heard on any city business?
Good evening, Dave Chesney, 30440 Normal. Yeah, first of all, I'd like to say congratulations to our 3 new officers. Like I said, my heart goes out to our first responders and our police. Only one thing, the gentleman at the last meeting on Normal, up on the next block from me, he said he got a ticket for expired plates, and it was on his birthday on a Sunday. Well, according to the Secretary of State, you have until the next business day to renew your tabs, because your tabs, they do expire on your birthday. I just had an incident with Clinton Township Police where they pulled up right behind me, pulled me over and said my plates were expired. And I said, well, look at my registration. Look at my birthday's the 26th. You're wrong. You know, and he said, oh, yeah, I apologize. And I was very upset about it. I said, you don't need to be pulling people. My stuff is right, you know. So that shouldn't happen. And like I've talked before about, you know, Lansing is not playing fair when it comes to municipal finance. And, you know, especially like this rule they want to pass, where it's going to say they're going to take away municipalities' right to enforce code enforcement on short-term rentals. No, we got to step in and fight Lansing and say, no, our municipalities need that, because we're not the rich communities like Traverse City and Petoskey, Charlevoix, where all the politicians have their places. They don't worry about rental properties because it's all the rich. We're working blue-collar communities. We need to stand up and be able to enforce our rental codes. You know, stability and quality of life, to me, matter. And all of South Macomb County, to me, matters. And this election coming up, Mayor Taylor, Mr. Watisha, Mr. Shoemaker, Ms. Haggerty, you have my vote. As long as you guys continue to keep this city moving forward and keep quality of life and stability a top priority, you have my vote. Thank you very much.
Anyone else in the public wish to be heard on any city business?
Arm wrestle.
Edward Jahowski, 26080 Linwood. Well, they got two gas stations left, one at 12 in Utica and one at that one that closed over here at Utica and Gratiot. I don't know what happened. There's no signs on a door. I don't know if
you're looking to buy it.
Abatement or something.
Mr. Sexton will probably have some answers for you when we're done.
And then that lane that's closed when they come around Utica with the pylons, that's full of garbage and debris. It should be cleaned up. And there's seven vacant buildings on Utica. They want to make that a nice area, but I don't think it's going to be, because they've got mostly cars. Looks like a used car lot. That Kroger's at 13 and Little Mac, that's Kroger's. Is that going to be a tax abatement too, like the store?
Does that conclude your remarks?
As Kroger's is going in there, taking that spot. One of the candidates wanted to say that they wanted to keep people in Roseville. Well, I got a list of people that moved out to Birmingham, Chesterfield, Macomb. One went out to Belleville, living in my area, Grosse Pointe Woods, Birmingham. And in my section, out of 20 houses, there's 10 of the houses that are rented. And those houses aren't being kept up. I don't know what code enforcement is doing, but the houses aren't kept up, so I don't know what to do about it. I lived there 40 years, and when I moved in, the guy come down the street, and he said, something's out of order, and I give you 2 days to fix it, and you fix it. There's nothing like that now. They get to Section 8, then people come in there, and they ruin the house. So I got some... That's about all I got to say. I got some pictures showing the neighborhood if you want to look at them.
Thank you. That's about all. Thank you. Mr. Mr. Sexton, is there anything you'd like to?
Yes, Mayor. If he were to provide me the addresses of the houses on his street, I will check into those properties to see if they have valid registrations or if there's any code enforcement issues at those properties. Also, the Kroger gas station at 13 Mile and Little Mac did not receive any type of tax abatement.
Yeah, I have not heard anything either. Thank you. Anyone else in the public wish to be heard on any city business?
Mike Clover, 29130 East Brittany Court, Roseville. A couple things. It's been a while. A couple things. I'm not used to this cooler weather we're having. I guess I get used to it eventually, but I guess we were all spoiled. And I also guess it's the end of October, so I guess we're due. So don't worry about me. I get used to it after a while. We always do. Second, in a more serious tone, I would just, on behalf of the Monsignor Stapleton Council 3191 out of St. Peel Parish in Roseville, I would like to thank everybody that showed up for our MI fundraiser recently at Ram's Horn Restaurant. It was quite a success. I know we're thinking of having it again in the spring and maybe a few Knights of Columbus fundraisers in between then. But I'll keep you posted if we do. But it was very successful, and I thank all the people who did show up and ate and had a good time socializing and so forth. The owner of Ram's Horn was very good to us. He was very enthusiastic. In fact, he was the one that suggested that we have more fundraisers, so we're seriously taking his word into consideration, and I guess as he was very forthcoming and very honest and very enthusiastic, and the owner of Ram's Horn needs to be commended for a job well done. Thank you, Ted. And third, I was wondering what was happening with Pizza Hut at 13th Masonic and Gratiot area. Last I heard, it was supposed to be turned into a Chinese restaurant, but I haven't heard anything since, and I've seen the signs up there for Pizza Hut still. Did that fall through or what? Besides that, I wish everybody a happy Halloween. Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Sexton?
The plans for the Pizza Hut at that location are still, they are going to close. They are moving down the street to 14 Mile and Gratiot. The plans are still in the works to demolish that building and build a new restaurant, Panda King, or Panda Express. I think they're waiting till they have the new store ready.
Anyone else in the public wish to be heard on any city business? If not, we'll move into items for discussion by City Council. Councilman Frontera.
Thank you. I first want to start off by congratulating our new officers and thanking our police reserve retirees for their service. As was mentioned, Halloween is next week, so be extra vigilant when driving, looking out for the trick-or-treaters. The Rec Authority's trick-or-trunk will be at Veterans Memorial Park this Saturday. It's probably already sold out, but if anybody does have a wristband, if there's inclement weather, it will be moved to the Rec Center. So check up with their Facebook page or call the Rec Department if there's any concerns or questions regarding that event. You know, there's a lot of crazy accusations thrown out earlier about accepting bribes or whatever, but I can tell you, you know, the Rizzo contract was approved well before I was elected, well before Mr. Watisha was put on the board. I've never accepted anything from anybody, no campaign contributions like that from any group like Rizzo. As was mentioned, the election for city council is in a couple weeks. I just want to say that with Veterans Day following right after that, there's no better way to honor veterans than to exercise your right to vote. It takes a lot of time, courage, guts to put your name on the ballot and run for election. I know I did it a couple times myself before getting up here. So everybody who's running, I wish you all the best of luck. I haven't seen any anything too crazy, mudslinging or anything like that. Everybody's done a great job. So please remember to vote. And with that, I have nothing else to say. Thank you.
Thank you. Councilman Watisha.
Thank you, Mayor. First, Chief, thank you for your program tonight. I appreciate it. You always do a great job. I want to congratulate our new officers and welcome them. We got Lauren, Matthew, and Jeff. I know they'll do a great job for the city. Also want to thank our retirees from the police reserves. That's all volunteer. I have to stress that really a lot. There's a lot of people in the city that does a lot of volunteer work, all our boards, commissions, and so on and so forth, and we really do appreciate it. Thank you, and good luck on your retirement, you guys. Thanks. Also, like Halloween is coming up next week. Be careful. Kids are all running around. Drive slow, bright lights, all that kind of stuff. And in 2 weeks from tonight, go out and vote. We all appreciate it. Thank you, Mayor.
Thank you. Councilman Shoemaker.
Thank you, Mayor. Where is our city manager's library report when I need it? This Thursday through Saturday, I don't have the times, in the Aaron Auditorium, the Friends of the Library are having their annual or biannual book sale. So please make it out and take a look at the books. They work real hard on that sale. Don't have the time. That's why I need Scott right now. Okay. Congratulations to the new officers. Welcome aboard, Lauren, Matthew, and Jeffrey. Thank you. Welcome aboard. And also want to thank the police reserves that received their retirement tonight. 17, 22, and 30 years. They've been around for a long time. Back many years ago, we had several church festivals and Halloween time and the parking lots during Christmas. They put a lot of hours in. I just want to thank all of them for their service. That's all I have, Mayor. Thank you.
Thank you. Councilwoman McCartney.
Thank you, Mayor. I, too, would like to thank our police officer reserves for all their years of service and congratulate our new police officers. And a happy Halloween to all of you, and please be safe. And that's all I have.
Thank you. Councilwoman Haw.
Thank you, Mayor. Also, congratulations to the chief on a nice presentation to our new police officers, and welcome to our police officers. And also, thank you for the service to our reserves. It is a volunteer job, and they've put in many years, so we do appreciate everything that they have done for the city. I also like to send my condolences to our Court Administrator Melissa King in the passing of her father. Our prayers go out to you. And Halloween, please, everybody, it's a great time for kids all to be out in the streets, going door to door. Please drive safely. Watch out for the kids. They sometimes dart into the streets. So let's have a nice, happy, and safe Halloween. Also, please exercise your right and get out and vote. That's all I have, Mayor.
Thank you. Mayor Pro Tem Haggerty.
Thank you, Mayor. Thank you, Chief Berlin, for a nice program tonight, and welcome and congratulations to our new officers. We have the finest, I think, in the state of Michigan, so you can be proud of your department. Thank you for our reserve officers for everything that they have done, and I wish them well, and thank them for their service. And Halloween, please be safe this holiday. It's can be a scary time when everybody gets all dressed up and things go crazy out there. And my condolences to Melissa King on the passing of her father. And please don't forget to exercise your right to vote on November 7th. And that's all I have, Mayor.
Thank you. Chief, once again, another great presentation you've did, you and your honor guard and your deputy chief. I want to thank you. I'm sure that your new police officers are very happy with the way things are going, so thank you very much. And also congratulations with the appointment to the medical marijuana board by the governor. It's a pretty high honor, and I want to congratulate you on that, and I know you'll do us right in Lansing. A couple weeks ago, I had an opportunity to speak to the Boy Scouts from Huron Park, which is 1412, and I hope to have them here in a couple weeks to do the Pledge of Allegiance. So I want to say, have a shout out to them and tell them thanks for inviting me to their Cub Scout meeting. And I want to congratulate our Roseville Panthers for making the playoffs. They have a game Friday where they play Port Huron Northern. The first game in the playoffs, I believe it's the first game I think they've had in about 7 or 8 years in the playoffs. So I want to congratulate them and their new coach. It's quite a feat. We've always had some teams that have always been very competitive, but when you make the playoffs, it's a pretty honorable thing. Folks, we've heard some things up at the podium today, and I only got one thing to say is, you know, people come up and they make accusations. Sometimes a glass of water is full and sometimes it's half empty. I think there was a lot of half empty glass of water tonight. And my feelings are people in glass houses shouldn't throw stones. So I think that with that, we should just make sure we have our ducks in a row before we make comments at any meeting in front of the public. Other than that, I have nothing else. Mr. Sexton, thank you very much for filling in for Mr. Atkins. I'll need a motion for adjournment.
So moved.
Support.
I have a motion by Mayor Pro Tem Haggerty, supported by Councilman Wetisha. All in favor?
Aye.
Meeting's been adjourned.